go with Match Game 74, production number 0151, air date to be announced, VTR 2274, let's take one. Get ready to match the star, Larry Blyden, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Kaye Stevens, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Hello, celebrities. I thank you for the warmth of your greeting, and I thank you for joining us. And shall we have a special greeting for the two new kids on the block, Larry Blyden and Kaye Stevens, shall we? Okay. They've never been on our show before, and we're very happy to see both of them. Larry and I have worked together a great deal, of course, on What's My Line. He's a superb host of that show.
Thank you, Gene.
And at this instant, when you are watching this, he's in Bangkok. That's right.
What does that mean?
That means he's touring the Far East.
Oh, okay.
As soon as we finish, I'm leaving.
That's a very exciting trip you've got
planned. Yeah, it really is.
Great.
You're really going to Bangkok?
He's going to Bangkok and all those places.
Oh, yes. They have a lot of topaz there. Very cheap.
Cheap topaz.
Cheap topaz.
Cheap topaz. I'll make a note of it.
Kaye, it's a pleasure to do business with you.
I'm happy to be here. I watch the show every day.
At a girl?
Yes, I do, and I think you're gorgeous.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And you're going to follow yourself, right?
Yes.
On Tattletales.
Yeah.
Is that exciting?
Yeah, I guess
so. Who else? Are you the only one in this panel who's going to be on Tattletales? Yeah,
yes.
I guess so. But that's going to be very, very exciting. It follows this show, so be sure to watch it. All right, let's say hello to our two players over here and welcome them, Babette Rutherford and Paul Fisher. Hello there, Paul. Babette. Paul is a current champ. He has got an even $9,000 to his credit. And he's being challenged by Babette. We finished round one. He's ahead at the end of round one. The score is 4-2, and Babette's got her fingers crossed, and we're going to start round two right after we pass along this message to you. Here we are. Shall we? Okay, we're going to begin round two. 4-2 is the score, remember. You as a challenger will make a selection, Babette.
I'll take number A.
A is what she wants. Now, last time out, she matched Brett and Charles, so the two of you will not participate. Everyone else will. Are you ready?
I just saw that.
Here it is. When Frank wasn't looking, Sally stuffed marshmallows into her blank.
Question.
You want to answer it? You want to play a little game with me? You answer the question and I'll read your answer, all right?
As soon as I think of something wonderful.
That'll take a little while there. All right, Larry's ready, Charles ready. Oh, you're
Charles
not playing, Charles.
Playing.
I'm Elaine in Bangkok.
No, he's in Bangkok, all right. All right, Babette, the four that you are playing with are ready or will be trying to match. Now we need your response. When Frank wasn't looking, Sally stuffed marshmallows into her...
Bra.
Bra. She said that with a rising inflection.
Yes, she did.
That's her answer, Larry. What's yours?
Well, I tell you, I'm an Eastern boy.
You're an Eastern boy, yeah.
And so I fought down bra, unfortunately, and wrote purse.
Purse. you're being
off
hissed by the audience.
Off to a roaring start.
Yeah. That's
all right, so let's come down here to Elaine Joyce. What do you say?
Well, it was going to be a long night.
Yeah.
So she popped him in her sweater.
Ah, oh, she did? Now, in order to stay in the game, Babette, and achieve a tie, you must match Richard and Kaye. May we see your answer, please,
well,
Richard?
I have a question, first of all. As sweater got a buzzer, does that mean she's braless as far as the judges are concerned? Either that or she's doing a Sydney Green Street impression, but I put bra.
Bra. Okay. Babette must match you to stay in the game. May we see your answer?
Well, I think anybody that puts marshmallows in their bra, I've done it. It's bra.
All right.
So, you did what you had to do, Babette. So at this moment, the score is 4-4. We'll go to Paul's question. Paul, you need one match to win your fifth game. Now, let's see. Last time out, you matched that position, that one, and that one. So this is only for Brett and for Elaine, okay? You two ladies only.
Talk about pressure.
One of the sailors...
Uh-oh.
On the Santa Maria said, just between us, I think a Christopher Columbus is... blank. Aren't you sorry you're not playing this round, Kaye? Kaye is hysterical.
I do it home alone all the time.
Okay, the two ladies are finished, Paul. Remember, you need one to win the game. Just between us, I think Christopher Columbus is...
gay.
How long have they been at sea at that point?
Their 27th day out. All right, Brett.
Okay, you should have discovered the Canary Islands.
Yes. Let's find out what happens. His answer is gay. Brett, what is yours?
This is the Santa Maria we read about in all our school books
in
and all
school
that swell
books.
Stuff.
Yes,
our Mr. Columbus.
Right, our Mr.
They
Columbus.
They said he's wrong.
Wrong! Wrong. Okay, now we come to Elaine.
Yeah. it was a long journey.
Yeah.
And, I hate to distort history, but maybe he was.
Yeah. Congratulations. Another game for you. Another $100 for you, too. Well, Babette, we've certainly enjoyed meeting you. You're a marvelous contestant and a very pretty lady. We've got a gift for you backstage. Many thanks for being
with
us on Match Game 74. Babette Rutherford. For you, we'll get back to you for the Big Money Super Match right after we pass along this message for all our friends out there.
GSN presents Behind the Blank. Legendary announcer Johnny Olson worked on what other game show? Was it Tattletales, The Price is Right, Tic-Tac-Toe, or all of the above? Stay tuned for the answer. Johnny Olson was the announcer for which show? The correct answer is D, all of the above. Johnny Olson was the original announcer for The Price is Right. He was the first to ask contestants to come on down. Stay tuned for more of that 70s Hour on GSN.
Okay, here we go with Paul Fisher, who has won his fifth game. And now he's going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match here, where he can win over $5,000. Are you ready, Paul?
Absolutely.
All right, you look kind of calm today.
I'm very calm.
Okay, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Buddy Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often, as you know, is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second, $250. Third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to give you a little help. Please choose them one at a time.
How about Dick Dawson?
How about Dick Dawson?
My old friend, Buddy Hackett.
Buddy Hackett. There's one answer. Another one?
How about Kaye Stevens?
Kaye Stevens, what do you say? Buddy...
I would think a buddy system.
Buddy system. Mm-hmm. That's when you go swimming and you have to have a partner who's
handy.
You're not too thrilled with her answer. All right, there's two. One more.
Yeah, let's go with Elaine, since she was so good to me.
Let's go with Elaine.
Okay.
Where would you like to go, Elaine?
how about Buddy Boy?
Buddy Boy. Now, Paul, you have Buddy System, you have Buddy Hackett, and Buddy Boy. You may choose one of those as the answer, or give us one of your own, but now we call for an answer. What do you want to do?
I'd like to go with Buddy Hackett.
Yeah. Buddy Hackett. That's the answer we are looking for. He's hoping it's under the $500 response. We'll work our way up to that first. May we see the $100 response. Buddy Boy is up there, the one Elaine gave you. That may be a good omen, Paul. We'll find out. Still looking for Buddy Hackett. Here is the $250 response. Buddy Ibsen. Good answer. Yeah.
How quickly we forget.
How quickly we forget, right. All right, third and last chance to find Buddy Hackett. Buddy Hackett, where are you? Are you under the $500 response? Yes! So, Paul, another $500 for you. That means now you'll be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect, remember, you got to match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be exact. Please choose one now.
I got to go with Dick Dawson.
All right, Richard Dawson. You will write, as you know. Paul will face me. I will get the $5,000 question. Here we go. Blank play. P-L-A-Y. Blank play. Or blank play. All right, he has finished with his answer. And, Paul, it's up to you now to fill in that blank in a way you think will match. Richard Dawson, blank play.
Well, this is really from left field, but I'll say legitimate.
Legitimate play. When you said left field for a second, I thought you were going to refer to something in baseball there. But we'll find out right now. He says legitimate play to match you. All right, for $5,000, Richard, may we see your card?
I thought we had it. I said triple play.
Triple play. Yeah.
Get out. Get
out. All right, you've enriched yourself by another $600. Means you're up to $9,600. And you're going to meet another player. So let's welcome B.J. Musler. Hello, B.J. All right. You know Paul Fisher, B.J.?
Yeah. Congratulations.
She's congratulating him. And BJ, would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay, I'm from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Yep.
And I've been living in Long Beach for the past 6 months. And I'm married, and I like to play a lot of tennis.
You play tennis?
Almost every day.
Have you played that for a long time?
Yes.
You must be very good.
Fair. I beat my husband. Uh-huh.
Is he here?
Yeah, you do.
But not for long.
Yeah. He's there?
There he is.
Well, are you a beginning tennis player, sir?
No. No. That's the gentleman with the tennis ball in his mouth.
Yeah, that's right. You're going to root for your wife, right?
I certainly am.
Okay. All right. Good luck to both players. Shall we begin?
Okay.
BJ, I push this button here, reveal two questions in round one, and you as a challenger make a selection. We ask you to do that because some contestants find some questions harder than others. What do you say?
I'll take B.
She wants B. Everybody plays. Brand new game. This is it.
Okay.
All right.
Tom Thumb said, there's this really great exotic dancer at the Bijou. She's only 3 inches tall, and she does her dance with a blank. Did you follow all that?
One more time.
Thank you for asking. Tom Thumb said, there's this really great exotic dancer at the Bijou. She's only 3 inches tall, and she does her dance with a blank. Now, don't think too hard.
Oh. Oh.
You're ready. Good for you.
I'm ready, practically.
You said not to think so hard.
That's right. I don't want anybody to strain anything. Brett, we're waiting for you.
Listen, I'm ready, sweetheart. Just as ready as rain.
Kay, what are you doing over there?
Writing her mother.
Okay. All right, they're all set. So, BJ, we call on you for a response. She's only 3 inches tall, and she does her dance with a...
A midget? A dwarf? I don't
know. A midget or dwarf. That's her answer.
I can't think of anything else.
She's at 3 inches, you know, is about this tall. Are you aware of that?
Oh, 3 inches.
Yeah, all right. That's her answer. Okay. Midget or dwarf. We have to accept that. Larry, what do you say?
I can only say I'm disappointed.
Why?
Because I can't see her act.
Is
I think she'd do it with a feather.
A feather, yeah. Small feather, yeah, good answer. Brett, what did you say?
I don't mean to stop a game in progress, but I have an announcement to make.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Now hear this.
Charles Nelson Reilly is not wearing any socks again.
Again.
Thank you. It's all right, Mrs. Reilly.
Pantyhose.
I said pigeon feather.
Pigeon feather. No
because
match
it's little,
there.
She was only 3 inches tall.
Yeah, that's right. That'd do it. Midget is the answer.
I might not have any socks, but I have the best answer on this floor. It requires a lot of thought, but then she'd get a laugh after a while. She does it with a magnifying glass.
Okay. Elaine. Hello, darling.
Well, 3 inches, I mean, that's almost nothing, right? You can't even put taps on your shoes. I said she does it with her trained flea.
Does a dance with a trained flea. Oh. Okay.
You gotta look quick.
That's right. What do you say, Richard?
Well, I happen to know this little darling.
Oh, really?
She did work with a midget at one time. It was like dancing with the Jolly Green Giant, but I put feather.
Feather in here.
She had right here.
Right there.
The rest of it.
Yeah.
That's strange. I was going to write feather, but I thought a feather would give her a hernia. Therefore,
so
I wrote bead. A
small
single bead.
Yes.
Like
okay.
A bubble, as it were.
DJ, you didn't do well with that at all, I'm sorry to say. And Paul, we'll get to your half of round one, but first we've got to get to this little bit of business for you, and here it is. Here we go. We're going to go to the second half of round one. You ready, Paul?
Absolutely.
Everybody plays.
Oh, goody.
Ewell Gibbon said... Oh, no, he said... He said, almost everything is edible. Then he proceeded to eat his blank. Ewell Gibbon said that. Almost everything is edible, and then he proceeded to eat his blank. Isn't that a dandy?
I'm finished, Larry.
Give him a raise. Whoever wrote that one, give him a raise. That's a terrific question.
I know him. I know him.
Okay. Everybody ready there. Charles.
Charles can't get his act together.
Okay, they're all set. Paul, Ewell Gibbon said almost everything is edible, and then he proceeded to eat his...
Hat.
I would have said something like belt or, you know, something that had been an animal once. What did you say, Larry?
Well, I didn't say that.
You didn't say that?
No.
You didn't say hat or belt or anything?
I said wallet.
Wallet is good. That's a good answer.
Is that good? Does it taste good?
Yeah, they're terrific. You gotta boil them first. Salt and pepper, a little monosodium glutamate, you never know. What do you say, Brett?
I think wallet's a lousy answer.
What do you got?
No offense, Larry.
Oh, she is offensive, Larry. Don't
I'll
worry about
it. Whether or not there's offense.
You've noticed with Ewell Gibbons, when he eats, he always eats like this with just one little hand, like
yeah.
that?
Yeah.
Well, that's because he ate his arm.
Yeah. Okay, all right. Hat is the answer.
He was
going to
go for the cat, but he was hungry, so he had poodle parmesan. He had the door.
Oh.
Betty White will get
so
you.
Doris.
Ewell Gibbons and almost everything else. Then he proceeded to eat his.
Well, he's not going to have much left because he ate his foot.
Uh oh. His foot and his arm and his wallet
foot.
And. What are you
I'm
offering?
Glad we got to me before he ate himself.
Hand is the answer Paul is looking for. What have you got?
You're
shall I preview your answer?
It's true. Wait a minute.
Oh, all right.
He ate his shorts. Because they were fruit of the loom.
Kaye is having the best time.
Gene?
Yes, Larry.
Gene?
Yeah.
Who's Ewell Gibbons?
All right, let's press on now. We got to go to round two, no? We're not going to round two. Oh, we're going to a commercial. Oh, all right. Anything you say, because you're on the ball game. Here we go to a commercial, but don't go away. Our time is up for today. So we finished round one. even Stephen, neither one of you scored. And we'll go to round two next time we get together and see how this game ends. And we'll look forward to seeing you, as we will you.
Oh, you thank you.
Beautiful, gifted bunch of coconuts. Listen, Kaye Stevens has had the best time of anyone I've seen around here in ages. We just, during the commercial break, we had to get her some Kleenex because she's laughing so much she's crying.
Oh, I ruined my makeup.
Aren't you glad you came?
Yeah, I love it. I
good.
Love this show.
I think she's having a nervous breakdown.
Richard?
Yes, sir.
You have a word of wisdom for us before we depart?
I think we already
yes,
heard. Conserve energy.
Conserve energy.
Makes love slowly.
Good idea. Good idea. Sue Rayburn here, hoping you'll be able to join us next time for Match Game 74.
Today's consolation prizes are WestFox Big Ben Futura, traditional Big Ben quality, colorful, easy-to-read dials, adjustable alarm from WestFox, a Cali Industries company. And heavy-duty Glamourine rug shampoo, the rug cleaner that's the efficient, easy way to clean or brighter rugs from Glamourine. And Profiles, with a special formula of crack, feed, and heat germ, tastes so good everybody will enjoy it. Delicious Profile, a family affair. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.